There are men who are still committing adultery. There are men who are still hurting their wives. It's not enough to say, oh, you two wait for her. No. If as a man, babe, you know you cannot tolerate me when we're sleeping at night talking to my boyfriend, why should a man be doing that? Marriage is God's institution. If you want to be frolicking about, if you want to be sleeping with different people, then don't get married.
Hey guys, Blessing here. It looks like there's fire on the mountain again for Dion Osage, but this time with his former employee who goes by the name Peculia, or Pecky as she's fondly called. So apparently, Dion made some public claims about Pecky which did not go down very well with her. So in her own defense, she started to put up these cryptic messages. This one says, "I want to break record. Hope you're prepared." And a few minutes later, she wrote, "There is a big difference between walking away and dismissed. Illiterate." So apparently, Dion Osage was claiming that he fired her, but in her understanding, she walked away from the job. And then she wrote, "How can one illiterate come to Facebook and be deforming people's character? Oh, something needs to be done about it immediately." She didn't stop there. She still said, "Ambassador Dion Osage, come and define this fraud. You said Jubilee didn't receive the full cash, that your field worker ate the money. Can you explain this? More evidence loading. Stay tuned." So it still looks like Dion Osage has said that one of his employers or former employers ate or embezzled some money from the organization. And here is Peculia trying to prove him wrong, that there was no money embezzled. And she also put up a screenshot to that regard. And her next post was very shocking. And that one says, "A man that wants to sleep with another man's wife is evil. Evidence loading." You guys, this is quite serious, because we all know that Dion Osage and his wife are now entangled in what looks like it's going to become a messy divorce. But for a former employee to come and start to allege that Dion Osage tried to sleep with someone else's wife isn't looking too good for Dion Osage at the moment, especially if there is evidence to back it up. And of course, we all know that a lot of people have said in the past that Dion Osage is fond of getting involved in illicit affairs with his employees. There is no proof to that yet, but a few people have actually said, and I have heard in the past, that Dion Osage allegedly had something sexual going on with Blessing, who formerly worked with him before she got married. All those have remained allegations and hearsays and rumors, because no one has ever stepped forward with any proof or evidence. And now this lady, Pecky, is saying that she has evidence and that she is going to be coming forward with the evidence. So we are keeping our fingers crossed. But what really caught my attention was this comment by Oluyole Edith, and it says, "If you know Osage very well, you will be ashamed to associate with such character. I know Osage from home and all his dubious activities. Have you ever asked yourself, how can a man always have problems with people working with him, from Lydia, Okojie, Larry, Love Doctor?" Love Doctor is actually someone that I am going to be talking further about in this video, because I was actually seeing a few things about him online. Dion Osage alleged that Love Doctor was trying to snatch his now ex-wife from him when they were still together. Let me continue to read. "Love Doctor and went violent with Blessing in the office. A man without respect for a woman. You must be out of your mind." Okay, so about Love Doctor, his part of the story is quite interesting, because he is Dion's cousin and he was working for Dion Osage at his foundation at the time. And at that same time, he doubled as Dion's cameraman and PA. So somewhere along the line, for whatever reason best known to Dion, Dion Osage went on Facebook Live and publicly said that Love Doctor was trying to snatch his wife from him. Then he was still together with Winifred, and I also believe that that might have been one of the reasons he fired Love Doctor eventually. So I'm not very sure if you guys already saw my previous video that I did about Dion Osage recently accusing Reverend Funke Adejumo of being the one advising his estranged wife Winifred to leave him this time around. And I remember saying in that video that no human being on earth, no alien, no god can convince a happy woman to leave her matrimonial abode. And this seems like Dion Osage is just trying to use all these accusations to save face and cover his own failure and shortcomings as a man and as a husband. You guys, as you can tell, Winifred is a very beautiful woman. There is absolutely no doubt about that. But if Dion was home taking care of business and doing what he's supposed to do as a man, I don't think he would be worried about who is trying to snatch her from him. And besides, at the end of the day, it became very clear that that young man who goes by the name Love Doctor, who has now moved on with his life, was innocent all this while. And he had nothing to do with the accusation that was leveled against him. So it was just about Dion being insecure about himself and about his position as Winifred's husband. And I'm also convinced that the reason Winifred and Dion broke up is not because of a third party in their relationship, but because of their contrasting differences as a couple. Take a listen to this next clip.
There are men who are still committing adultery. There are men who are still hurting their wives. It's not enough to say, oh, you two wait for her. No. If as a man, babe, you know you cannot tolerate me when we're sleeping at night, talking to my boyfriend, why should a man be doing that? Well, why do you wait, babe, wait? Can you answer this? Why do you men think it is not okay for you to catch your wife cheating, but it is okay for you to bring home a second wife and a side baby? What gives you the impression that women are okay with that?
I mean, it is not okay for men to do that, but at the end of the day, you know, every one of us have feelings.
Wait, it is not okay for men to do that, but at the end of the day, every one of us have feelings. Like, you guys, here is Dion saying, look, a man's got to do what a man's got to do, because buddy no be firewood. But Winifred, on the other hand, is talking passionately about how wrong it is for men to hurt their wives by committing adultery. And Dion is also saying, look, madam, I admit it is wrong, but I have feelings that I'm not able to control. I am not in control of my urge to cheat on you, because my sexual feelings get the better of me.
But then again, it's an individual differences. There are some women that prefer their husband or their boyfriend to have more than one girl. There are some women that deprive pleasure from their husband or their boyfriend having a side chick. All right? And there are some women who also don't like that. So that's why it's important in a relationship, you have to get the kind of woman or the kind of man that fits your lifestyle. It's very important.
Babe, I know you are of this opinion and you always say this, but I put it to you that in such a relationship, there's no love, there's no care.
That's what you think.
No, it's not what I think.
So what we just listened to now is proof that Dion Osagie already recognized that he was with the wrong girl. Like, he was with the kind of girl that is strongly against the kind of life that he leads. And with that, I mean the life of being in an open relationship or an open marriage. With everything that they both said, you can see that Dion Osagie would rather be with a girl who doesn't mind him having a fling whenever he feels the urge to do so. But Winifred is clearly not that girl. And instead of Winifred to come to terms with her reality and reject what she doesn't want in her marriage, she remained in denial in that marriage, hoping and praying that perhaps God was going to touch this man and he would change for the better.
People say compromise in marriage. I am of the opinion now, at least I can also advise people in relationship, because I've been married to you now about 4 years. I am of the opinion that before you marry somebody, make sure that person loves what you love.
Loves cheating, loves exchanging partners.
Love,
that is not the will of God for marriage.
It's not the will of God, but it is what is happening. Do you know that the relationship whereby many women accept that their husband or their husband may cheat at the relationship that lasts the longest?
Oh my God, I just fainted. So according to Dion Osagie, the relationships in which women accept that their partner cheat are the relationships that last the longest. Now, in as much as adultery might not be the most ethical example of this principle, I must say that I quite agree with Dion Osagie on this one. Like, a relationship in which there are no boundaries, where everyone is free to do exactly what they want and live exactly how they want to live their life, is definitely going to last longer than a relationship in which you are committed to living by the vows that you made at the altar to someone. And my general take on this is that if you as a man or even a woman already know in your heart that you are not going to live by those vows that you are making at the altar, then please don't get married. I mean, why even go through all that trouble making a promise before man and God to be faithful to one woman or to one man, and then once you get married, you break your covenant? Then why do it in the first place? So for me, it's just a waste of money and time. Like, weddings are very expensive these days, and divorce proceedings and settlements could also be quite expensive. Not to talk about the fact that you just wasted 4 years of a woman's life going into a contract with her that you know that you are not fully ready to honor.
But there are some women who are willing to even bring a girl for their husband.
Sarah did it.
Okay.
But what happened at the end of the day? She sends the woman away. She forced her husband to sleep with the woman because she was unable to conceive. At the end of the day, she said, you cannot stay here, you must go, because she became pregnant. So we've seen all these things. However you want to turn it, the Bible is explicitly clear.
Okay, I know it might be quite easy for me to sit here and castigate Dion for simply being who he is and being open about it, but I'm also looking at Winifred closely, and one can't deny the fact that she has quite a sharp mouth, if that makes sense. I mean, most women do. But one thing we women need to be sensitive about is how we run our mouth when we are having a conversation with our husband. Like, I'm not saying that Winifred was being rude to Dion or anything, but I just feel like she was somewhat fierce in the way she was talking back at her husband, especially with the fact that they were having a public live stream. And I'm also certain that many Christian women out there look up to Winifred as a role model, and her countenance and approach towards her husband was not very complimentary. And of course, all of this would never matter at all in a different setting, but I have seen Winifred on a live stream with her mentor, Reverend Adejumo, and it's just so plain to see that Winifred is someone who would literally bow to her pastor and not even look them in the eye when talking to them. But I don't see that same level of reverence towards her husband. And I find that quite a pity that most women regard and also show more respect to their pastors more than they do to their husbands. But on the other hand, it's also really how you present yourself to a woman as her husband that she's going to carry you throughout the relationship or the marriage. So if you present yourself and behave like a complete jerk in your marriage as a man, you should also expect that same level of disregard from your woman.
Marriage is God's institution. If you want to be frolicking about, if you want to be sleeping with different people, then don't get married. How can you say you don't believe in God and you go get married and exchange vows?
The first step of getting married is to make sure you marry a person that loves everything you do.
Not everything. It can't be everything.
Why not?
Is she the exact same as you?
There are people who are exactly like you. You don't know that?
No, I mean, at the end of the day, babe, there's still going to be friction.
Yeah, of course. There's compromise. Okay, let's say majority of the things you do. Let's say everything. Let's say the person must like exactly what you do. It will not be a problem.
Yes, but then, babe, we cannot include sin into it now.
Sis, we can include sin into it, and we should actually include sin into it. Otherwise, you will continue to find yourself in this same hot seat, having the same draining argument with someone who you don't like majority of the things they like. So again, I agree with Dion. So Christian women out there, only marry a man of whom you like majority of the things he likes, and that includes sin. Otherwise, there will always be conflict and disagreement in your relationship unless that man is freely willing to give up on those things that you don't like, and also make sure that he does that and also gives his life to Christ before taking those vows. If not, you will be the one to lose out at the end of the day.
We're talking about relationship or being together. You have to look at both sides. You know, marry a man. Do you know that there are some women who are also looking for a man of the type you don't need to marry? There are women looking for a man that smoke to marry. There are women looking for a man they can go to club with. There are women looking for a man that can be sleeping with them and their friend. All these things are possible. So general solution to a better marriage is to marry a man or a woman that love the same thing as you,
not including sin. That's my taste.
But that's your taste because you're a Christian.
Yeah, because people want to live in sin. I cannot encourage, babe.
No, on this perspective,
babe, you should not be encouraging people.
We are not encouraging sin.
Yeah,
we are not encouraging sin. You look at it as a sin. All right,
but it's wrong.
Everybody have their freedom of expression.
Okay,
but we are living in an era whereby
the devil has taken over.
Okay, so
the world.
Maybe the devil has taken over, but my stand remains the same, that as a veteran in marriage, if you are going to marry, make sure you marry a woman that love what you do,
not the woman you love. Sin. Yes,
not the woman you love.
Yes. Not including sin.
You guys, so this argument between Dion and Winifred continued for over 30 minutes and they just couldn't agree about the definition of compatibility. And Winifred is clearly delusional and seems to be living in a world of fantasy and fairy tales. But I really do hope that at least she learned a thing or two from the outcome of this union with Dion. But my contention right here is that nobody caused their breakup. Love Doctor did not cause their breakup. Reverend Funke Adejumo did not cause their breakup. They broke up not because they are bad people, but because they are not the right person for each other. So I know I've totally digressed from the topic of this video, which is Peculiar's matter, but the latest on that story is that Dion fired back at Pecky by posting this not so flattering picture of her. He actually used this picture as his profile picture, which of course is savage, especially because of the fact that Dion has been posting very beautiful pictures of different beautiful women on his wall all week long. So for him to suddenly post this particular picture of Pecky was, like I said, pretty savage and petty. But we all know how Dion is. Anyway, I will continue to update you guys on this story as it unfolds. In the meantime, make sure you subscribe to this channel if you haven't already so that you don't miss anything. But if you get to watch this video on Facebook, then do not hesitate to like and follow my page, and I will catch you on my next one.